Hello, Lakers Nation. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com. Make sure you do subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Free agency officially kicks off tomorrow, 6 o'clock Eastern time, 3 o'clock Pacific. And according to a recent report, the Lakers are increasingly confident they can sign Bruce Brown when free agency does commence. Now, in order to sign him, we would have to imagine that the Lakers are going to need the full mid-level exception, and that's what we're waiting on. Talked about this in a video earlier today. We're waiting to find out what do the Lakers do with Malik Beasley and Mo Bamba. If the Lakers feel like Bruce Brown is indeed coming to LA, then what we will almost certainly see the Lakers do is cut ties with both Beasley and Bamba in order to free up that room to use the full mid-level exception. Now, if they are hearing that Bruce Brown is not going to sign with him, and again, right now, according to Jovan Buha of The Athletic, the report is the Lakers are confident they can. Mark Stein this morning had a report that a lot of teams are saying it's going to take more than the mid-level to get Bruce Brown. But if the Lakers feel confident they can get him, then declining the team option on Malik Beasley's $16.5 million deal for next season and waiving Mo Bamba, who has a $10.3 million non-guaranteed deal for next season, would make all the sense in the world. If they're not hearing that they're going to get Bruce Brown, though, there is another path to this where maybe it makes sense for the Lakers actually to pick up both of those contracts and have almost $27 million in expiring contracts to work with during the season. You can move them all the way up until the trade deadline to potentially go hunting for some type of move mid-season on the trade market, in addition to the fact that you'd probably have the taxpayer mid-level exception of $5 million to use. So the Lakers, depending on what they do with Mo Bamba and Malik Beasley, could have the full mid-level exception to use, or they could take the other path where they wind up having Mo Bamba and Malik Beasley on the roster. Who knows what kind of season either guy could have? That's something to factor in as well. Maybe Malik Beasley's shot comes back around. Maybe Mo Bamba turns into the we were hoping that he could be. In addition to that, you would have about $5 million to spend out on the free agent market. Certainly not enough to get Bruce Brown, but maybe enough to still go find somebody else in addition to veteran minimum contracts the rest of your way to fill out your roster. But Lakers Nation, give me your thoughts in the comments down below. Do you have a preference? Would you rather see the Lakers part ways with Mo Bamba and Malik Beasley? There is a chance you could still bring them back, but would you like to see them decline those deals and then go after Bruce Brown? Or should they keep Bamba and Beasley on the books and keep open the possibility of a big mid-season trade using those expiring contracts? Give me your thoughts in the comments down below. We'll keep you up to date on everything going on in the world of the Lakers heading up to tomorrow's free agency period. Till next time, everybody. See ya and stay safe.